ain't no need for none of that. There ain't no need for none of that. I told you, twice already, 1 point already.
Evander Holyfield can have as many as 5 minutes to recover from this. And now he says he's ready to go. Flip Bomanski, the Nevada State Athletic Commission doctor, is sitting in Holyfield's corner. Holyfield taking a couple of heavy shots.
Holyfield is really hurting. He looks like he's ready to go. He looks like
this is tremendous stuff.
Hard right hand inside by Holyfield. And now down goes Evander.
A right hand
by Bo.
A right hand inside.
Oh, he made it.
How do you feel? How do you feel? Take a step forward. Take a step forward.
How does he feel?
Take a step forward. Take a step forward.
Wonderful.
Terrific. Right, let's go.
This man out. He is just amazing.
His career is the end. The fourth, and that's it.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Pertandingan di Panther Holyfield versus Rudy Boy yang ketiga. Atau pertarungan yang dijuluki dengan pertarungan bab terakhir. Merupakan sebuah pertarungan 17 berat non gelar yang digelar pada tanggal 4 November tahun 1995 di Nevada, Amerika Serikat. Berbeda dengan dua pertarungan mereka sebelumnya. Jika pada dua pertarungan mereka sebelumnya berlangsung selama 12 ronde penuh. Namun pada pertandingan ini Kilo Petinju hanya menjalani ronde sampai ronde ke-8 saja. Panther Holyfield yang sepertinya masih didera masalah kesehatan. Sepertinya masih kurang siap untuk sepenuhnya dalam menjalani pertarungan ini. Di mana ronde ke-5 pertandingan ini, Panther Holyfield yang ternyata saat itu menderita hepatitis A, terlihat sangat kelelahan dan seperti kehabisan tenaga.
Now the right hand sharper by Bo and that one lands. Persistent theme in the trilogy, punching after the bell.
Well,
another uppercut by Bo snaps Holyfield's head back. Holyfield with some of the uppercut medicine for Riddick.
You need to punch this up, guys.
Di sepanjang jalannya ronde ke-5 pertandingan ini, Evander Holyfield yang ternyata saat itu menderita hepatitis A, terlihat sangat kelelahan dan seperti kehabisan tenaga. Dan dia harus menerima banyak hukuman dari Rudy Boy. Di sepanjang jalannya ronde ke-5 pertandingan ini.
Talk about the healing he received. This man is not able to catch a second wind. He's not able to get his recap diagnosed,
and that he's being bothered in some way now, just as he was against Michael Moore.
It's terrible. He's even more so now. He can't catch a deep another wind.
Bring up.
Throw in the towel. Okay. If I'm the Holyfield's corner, I throw in the towel.
Low blow, and Cortez penalizes Bo a point.
1 point, low blow. 1 point, low blow.
Gotta stop it.
You all right?
He's gotta stop.
You got some time. Let me know when you're ready. Ain't no need for none of that. There ain't no need for none of that. I told you, twice already. 1 point already.
Evander Holyfield can have as many as 5 minutes to recover from this, and now he says he's ready to go. Flip Bomanski, the Nevada State Athletic Commission doctor, is sitting in Holyfield's corner. Holyfield taking a couple of heavy shots.
Holyfield is really hurting. He looks like he's ready to go. He looks like he has nothing to get back. He just became 33 going on 53.
Evander Holyfield has never been knocked out in his
friend box. He's got heart trouble. It's evident he cannot get his breathing together. He can't recuperate.
Who claim it was misdiagnosed.
Hard right hand by Holyfield.
Here he is.
And remember, of course, that he got medical clearance from the commission.
We're here to make sure nobody takes unnecessary punishment.
Hey, Joe, take control of this thing.
Namun dalam keenam pertandingan ini, Bandar Olimpik berhasil mencatatkan dirinya sebagai orang pertama yang menjatuhkan David Boy ke kanvas, yaitu lewat sebuah pukulan tangan kirinya yang mengenai dagu David Boy. Namun David Boy masih berhasil untuk bangkit berdiri dan kembali melanjutkan pertarungannya.
Without snap now, what do you make of this, George?
George, you seem as stunned as everyone else. On the chin, that was not the one, although perhaps it contributed to the final blow. And there it is, that left hook. Downs, we have your hesitant in suggesting that something like this could happen again. So we...
Now they begin to trade again. Both men finding some of the snap in their punches in this last minute of round seven. Throughout the second of their three fights, Evander Holyfield, care to explain? You just don't feel as though you should comment on what you're
watching, is that it? Dan di ronde ke-8 pertandingan ini, Evander Holyfield mendatangi Ridik Boy dengan agresif, dengan melepaskan pukulan kombinasinya ke arah Ridik Boy. Namun Ridik Boy mampu membalasnya dengan pukulan tangan kanan pendek yang menjatuhkan Evander Holyfield ke kanvas. Namun Evander Holyfield masih mampu bangkit berdiri untuk menjawab hitungan ke-9 wasit pertandingan. Namun setelah pertandingan dilanjutkan kembali, Evander Holyfield dengan cepat dijatuhkan kembali oleh Ridik Boy, yang memang sewasit pertandingan untuk menghentikan pertarungan ini dan memberikan Ridik Boy kemenangan melalui technical knockout atau TKO di ronde yang ke-8. Di mana penghentian ini merupakan penghentian Evander Holyfield untuk pertama kalinya di sepanjang karir tinju profesionalnya.
There's the hard right hand that Holyfield landed in there, and then the right hand by Bo, and down with Evander would make it up from that one. Eventually he did, and referee Joe Cortez let him come back across the ring, and that's all it took to put the finishing touches on the knockout.
Applause for two warriors in the heavyweight division.